Toyota Supra twin turbo.
My name's Dave, the R34 GTR, single turbo.
Car for 13 years now.
I've had it coming up to about 3 years now.
It was colour was silver when I first got the car, with the standard bodywork on it. I then added a few other modifications, like a new front bumper.
When I got mine, it was pretty much stock, apart from some ABS wheels. I think that was it, just complete standard really.
The engine started off basically standard. I've since modified it myself to fully forged. I've got billet main bearings, standard crank, ACL race bearings. It's all ARP fasteners throughout, forged pistons. The head is a stage 5 race head with Ferrier 1mm oversized valves, 280 degree cams. Rev limit's been raised to 8,500. I've got a valve side inlet manifold. The exhaust is a 4-inch boost logic with a custom 4-inch mid-pipe joining to the twin 3-inch HKS downpipes. Racing developments. I've also done first engine startup and put the base map on.
Mine, engine wise, is stock internals, but I've gone single turbo conversion with a precision 6262 ball bearing twin scroll turbo on a 6 boost manifold, turbo smart 50mm wastegate with a screamer, injector dynamic 850 injectors, Tomy cams, HKS adjustable gears, Nismo intercooler, custom turbo pipe work done myself. What else have I got on it? 3.5-inch turbo back exhaust to custom downpipe to a Blitz Nurspec 4-inch. Yeah, I think that's it.
Wheels are Axe AP30s with 265 35 18s on the rear and 235 35 18s on the front. They've been on the car for approximately 12 years, but I've put them on pretty much just after I first bought the car.
I've got 720 model 46s. 18 by 10.5, got them at Christmas a few months ago, on 265 35 18 Goodyear Eagle F1 tyres.
Mods I first started putting on pretty much straight after I got the car, from Dulock front bumper to going BPU up in the boost on the stock twins as it was back then. 3-inch exhaust.
I started doing my mods, the small ones, when I first got the car, just like gauges, got some new seats, but I spent a fair bit recently on all the engine mods. But then I got a few carbon bits, carbon bonnet, some carbon canards, carbon boot lip spoiler, higher spoiler legs, but yeah, that's it for now really.
After getting the car eventually back on the road last August, I managed to get the car to JE Auto Extravaganza. That was last year, and this year I've been to Japfest at Silverstone.
I had to do some last minute mods, well, head gasket and a few other bits, to late nights to get to BHB show in Linden Hill, which was waste of time because it was pouring with rain and cold and wet. Then I went to North Wheel with Test and Tune, packed, so you didn't manage to get any race tickets for the quarter mile. Should try and attend Japfest 2, I think it's at Donington, the Jap shows at Centre Pod, maybe a few others.
racing elements, which is Lee Perryman, and some second-hand parts as well, which when he was breaking his car. The help I had in rebuilding the engine was my son. We spent many hours standing in the garage rebuilding the car and the engine.
I got all my bits, most of them, from All Extreme, Conceptor Tuning, a few bits from the forum, a couple bits from Japan, and my mate Nick gave me a lot of help.
Next modifications, I hope, is I need some new brakes to get the original J-Specs uprated, some wider wheels on the back, and quite possibly a new gearbox to take the power.
I got some rear disc and pads going on as well. Mods wise, really, there's not really much else I want to do, but I do want to get the front end painted again, all the stone chips. Got to do my side skirts again. My cousin Gary at CNR Motors is doing that for me. Yes.
What I love most about the car is being back behind the wheel driving it again after 4 years of being off the road. My favourite part of the car is probably the engine bay and the interior. I spent a lot of hours doing work on that.
I do have a lot of favourites, but I think it's got to be the colour. And I've done some custom angel eyes, which I'm sure they'll do a video of it.
After all the mods have been done, there's no way I'm going to be getting rid of this car in the foreseeable future. So I just enjoy getting back behind the wheel, just driving it again. There's no way I'll fancy ever doing that work again.
Basically what you said, prices have gone ridiculous now, so it's an investment for me. And if I sold it, I'd never ever get one, because price is just stupid and I enjoy it too much.
Thanks for the photographers for the great day, another photo shoot.
Again, what he said, good day out. Recording for a long time.